Very good morning, my dear students. Today you are going to learn a electrooccultogram. This is a new topic. You have already come across a electrooccultogram. So here electrooccultogram, we know that is it is used to recording the electrical signal by a eye movement. So we can say that electrooccultogram here you are seeing that. In this case there is a positive electrode and a negative electrode which is placed over the forehead and below the eye, and here there is a eyeball movement have been recorded, and we can say that electrooccultogram it is a method of recording the electrical signal due to the eye movement. So here we can say that it is electrooccultography. That is, graphy means recording a eye movement of a eyeball. That is okay. It is a method for sensing eye movement and is based on recording the standing corneal retinal potential arising from hyperpolarization and depolarization existing between the cornea and the retina. This is commonly known as the occlogram. That abbreviation is EOG. So it is a method of recording the eye movements. We can use to record the eye movement during the sleep. What is the eye movement during the sleep and also in a dream? This is mainly used for research purpose. So how our sleeping pattern, in that what is the eye movement, they are many kind of information they are obtaining with the help of these sleep and dream. In that what is the eye movement, it is recording eye movements from infant and children in order to evaluating the reading ability and visual fatigue. The EOG, that is called electrooccultogram, potential or picked up by small surface electrode which is placed on the skin near the eye. Here they are using one pair of electrode which is placed above and below the eye to pick up the voltage corresponding to vertical movements of eyeballs, and another pair of electrodes is positioned to placed left and right of the eye to measure the horizontal movement of eyeballs. So here they are measuring two kind of measurement. One is a vertical movement of eyeball, another one is a horizontal movement of eyeball. For that they are using a four electrodes. Two electrode is used to obtain the electrical signal due to the vertical movement of eyeball. Another two electrode is used for obtaining voltage by movement of a horizontal movement of a eyeball. So here there is a pen recording which is connected at the center of a recording paper, and corresponding to voltage changes accompanying it. Therefore the EOG as having most application for research work, and here this EOG is commonly not used in a clinical purpose. Only for the research purpose they are using this EOG. Next one. So what is the uses of EOG? EOG, it is used for detection. So for EOG detection, they are using a 4 to 5 electrodes which are used to record acquiring the EOG signal. So here these electrode, other name is called the transducer. Why we are calling as a transducer? It is converts a movement of I into electrical signal, that is the purpose of this electrode. So that's why we are calling electrode as a transducer. So in this case, we know that there is a two pair of electrodes are placed over the eye, that is near to the eye skin, and we can say that the two electrodes are placed on a outer side of other eye, and another two electrodes are placed above and below the eye. So above and below the eye, we are calling as a it is used to measure the vertical movement of a eyeball, and we can say that the placed on outside of the eye, it is used to measure the horizontal movement of electrodes. Here four electrodes are used. One more electrode is used as a reference electrode or a ground electrode. So now you are seeing that I have already seen that here they are using a five electrodes. Two electrode is used for a vertical movement of a eyeball, that is placed above and below the eyeball. Okay, above the electrode placed above and below the eyeball, that is gives a vertical movement of a eyeball, has been converted as a electrical signal. And side outside of the eyeball, it is used for picking the horizontal movement of eyeball. So that is given through the horizontal channel. So this another electrode which is act as a reference electrode or a ground electrode, that is fifth electrode. So here totally five electrodes are used here. So usually in a clinic, in a research purpose, they are coloring some electrodes. And here we know that there is a two pair of electrodes. One is horizontal electrodes, another one is vertical electrodes. So horizontal pair of electrodes having positive electrode, that is denoted by H plus, and a negative electrode which is denoted by H minus. Another vertical electrodes also having pair, that is a positive electrode is a V plus, denoted by V plus, and a negative electrode is denoted by V minus. So ground have been referred as a R2. So this is one. Okay, here the electrography is based on electrical sensor that are attached to the skin around the eye and measure the changes in electric field produced by the eye rotation. This process is based on existence of a permanent potential difference between the cornea and the eye fundus of approximately, which provides 1 millivolt. Here it is a small voltage difference appears around the eye as well as the eye position varies. Usually that is we are here using carefully located electrodes, that is the horizontal and vertical movement that can be easily recorded by these electrodes. The disadvantage of EOG is that signal is changes may also appear when there is no eye movement. That is a disadvantage. So here the oculography is considered to be a less reliable for quantitative measurements, particularly for medium and large socket tips. So and the other here we should not see the disadvantage also. Advantages also is there. The advantage of this method is, which is a rather non-invasive method and is able to record a large eye movements for the research purpose. So this method is also able to record the eye movements when the eyelids is closed. So we can say that the EOG voltages are higher than EEG signal because the eyeball, that is eye, is outside of the skull structure, there is no bone to attenuate the signal, that's why it is provides a amplitude is larger than a EEG signal. So in this case, the cornea, that is a front one, has a positive polarities, so that why the positive electrode are placed there. The retina, that is the back side of a eyeball, that has a negative polarity, that's why they place the negative electrode that side. So positive electrode is placed near the cornea, negative electrode placed near the retina position. So EOG placed, that is called LOC and ROC, that is what we can say means a left oculogram and another right oculogram, which is on the outer canthus. So outer canthus, these electrode where they are placing means they are placing outer catalyst. What is the meaning of outer catalyst means? That is the outlet or inner corner of the eye where the upper and lower lids are meet place, that name is called canthus. Canthus, that is called canthus. They called as a C-A-N-T-H-U-S, canthus. Okay, so here the EOG is placed on the outer canthus of the eye, offset that is 1 centimeter below the LOC and 1 centimeter above the ROC are placed, that is electrode are placed in the horizon. Here the EOG pickups the inherent voltage of eye during the eye open awakefulness. The sharp deflection in the EOG tracing may indicate the presence of eye blinks. Now we'll see that here you are seeing that the forehead, the one we are calling as a ground reference electrode, or we are calling as a that is a electrode position of a R, horizontal electrode named as a H plus H minus, which is used to measure the or recording the horizontal eye movement, and vertical electrode is represented by V plus V minus, which is placed vertical eye movement in order to recording the electrode position. So here now we'll see that what is the physiology vision and visual vision of these EOG recording. So here the EOG recording, the vertical lines represent alternating dipole or eye as moved from left to right, that is called vertical lines. So vertical lines means eye movement from left to right. The light rise is seen and increases in the height of the vertical lines as the light is switched on. So when the light is switched on, this movement will be very high. The oculogram, the EOG is measured that in terms of microvolts also. When the light is arises, that is increasing in amplitude as the light stimuli is increased. The standard curve is tells about the upper movement of eyeball and left and right movement of eyeball when the light is increased. Actual EOG values have been recorded, and it is initially at upper and lower, which provides the EOG amplitude versus time curves for a healthy subject. The actual EOG is estimated from points measured as a dashed line. So here another one, that Oculogram used to measure the rhythm sleep disorder. The name is called circadian rhythm sleep disorder, that is CRSD. So that occurs in the cornea retinal potential with the eye movement during the sleep and awakefulness. The cornea and retina from the dipole, with the cornea being a positive in relation to the retina. A movement of eyeball which changes the electrical signal in EOG, acquired by the EOG electrodes, which is recorded as a deflection. The EOG is important in evaluation of sleep and sleep stages. So another one also we can measure, that is REM, that is called rapid eye movement, or also can be recorded. And during the sleep also we can record these REM, that is rapid eye movement. So which are essential to measuring the REM sleep pattern. So these movement are seen as a sharp burst of electric activities at the time of sleep onset. Slow eye movement can be seen, it has been recorded as a electrical signal. So there you are seeing that electrode are placed above the eye, and here it will take the what we can say vertical movement of a eyeball, that has been observed by a ERG. And another one also can be observed, that is EOG also observed. EOG provides the frequency range is 0 to 50 hertz. You are seeing the waveform also corresponding eyeball movement, the amplitude have been varied according to this one. So here another one, this EOG is used for polygraphic recording techniques. So we can say that EOG's recording is crucial to staging the sleep accurately. Two recommended electrodes are labeled, that is one is E1, that is 1 cm, the left outer canthus, and E2, the placed 1 cm above the right outer canthus. So both reference to right mastoid, that is called mastoid means the part of the temporal bone, that they are placing the electrode. This allows the stimulation recording of both vertical eye movements such as blinking and horizontal eye movement such as slow and rapid movement. Here they are using the gold cup or silver chloride electrodes in order to record the acquire the eye movement. This can it is connected to the monitor of EOG. The underlining one, the concept is that the eye is an electrical dipole with a relatively positive at the cornea and a relatively negative at the retina. Any eye movements changes orientation of dipoles, and it is a movement of a dipole that is recorded as a potential difference between the two electrodes used to record EOG. In this arrangement, the conjugate eye movements produces out of phase deflection in the two channel, whereas EEG slow activity containing the eye electrodes are in phase. The sensitivity and filter setting for EOG are similar to those used in EEG signal. So here the eye movements are generally characterized of a sleep stage in which they occurs and an essential part of scoring. The eye blink seen only in awakefulness or conjugate with vertical eye movement occurring at 0.5 to 2 hertz with the eye open or closed. rabbit eye movement, that is a conjugate irregular sharp eye movement with an initial deflections of less than half a second, which occurs in a awakefulness along with the high chin EMG tone, eye blinks and posterior dominant rhythms, but they also occurs in a REM sleep, especially in a basic REM, where they occurs in a burst seen in all direction, in a, that is a horizontal, oblique and a vertical, and as a accompanied by low absent chin tone, that is intercepted with a similar pacing bursting, and a D, that is desynchronized and amorphous EEG pattern, which is in a REM sleep. So rapid eye movement, which is or frequently proceed by the sawtooth waveform that you are seeing in the figure. So although both occurs independently, the frequency with the burst of rapid eye movement occurs in a REM sleep, which is called the REM density. It is typically increase the later REM cycles during the course of normal PST. This may reversed in the patient with the depression. So here, what is the we can say means in this case. So the role of the EVOG is having a electrophysiology and psychophysics in order to measuring device. So here what they are doing, the patient is asked to continuously alternate his or her gaze between the fixation light at 1 second interval for 10 seconds every minute. The fixation lights are separated by a visual angle of 40 degree from each other and located in a diffusely illuminated gaze field sphere. Here the gas induced changes in the eyeball bulb angles alter the relative potential difference between the nasal and temporal electrodes. The gas induced potential difference is directly related to the size of the ocular resting potential. The gas induced modulation of potential is measured for about 30 minutes. The dark adoption of light adapted eye result in a decreases in the ocular resting potential, which reaches a minimum value after about 10 minutes. It is called a dark trot. During subsequent steady illumination of eye, a continuous rises in resting potential is evoked, which is reached to the so called light peak, that will be 8 to 10 minutes after the light onset. So here we can say that this one mainly used for a research purpose, for in order to measure the eyeball movement, either affected by the physiological condition or a psychological condition. We'll see it in the next class. Thank you for listening this class.